Top 5 features of iOS 18.1 in this video. Let's begin. What's up, Lollipop? My name is Joe, and in today's video, I'm going to show you the top 5 features of iOS 18.1. Finally, it has arrived. Everyone now with an iPhone 15 Pro, 15 Pro Max, 16, 16 Plus, 16 Pro, and 16 Pro Max can enjoy Apple Intelligence on their devices. Or if you have an iPad with an M1 processor or an A17 processor, or if you have a Mac with an M processor, then you can try this out. This episode is very heavily focused on Apple Intelligence because these are the most important new features. There's one that is not an Apple Intelligence feature and everyone can have, actually two, so let's begin. First of all, we have a new revamped Siri. If you summon Siri, that you see is now with a totally new animation. It's all glowing around your screen. It looks actually quite delightful, but that's not the only way you can talk to Siri. So if you want to actually type to Siri, you can do that. You tap here on the home bar or in the bottom of the screen, and then this keyboard comes up where you can ask Siri anything that you want via text. So you're not limited to speaking to Siri. You can type to Siri now on, and Siri has become a little bit more intelligent, a little bit better, not by much, but just a little bit. It's still a work in progress. It's nowhere near as comprehensive as, for example, ChatGPT. It can turn on and off your lights and it can open your garage, but you know, it can't really do anything much more than that. For that, we need to wait until iOS 18.2, which is coming later this year. Siri is okay. Siri can actually, I just summoned it for myself. Siri can actually now understand you if you make a mistake. So if you say something like you want the weather for a specific location, but then you change your mind and you say another location, then it will be able to do that. So I'm going to demonstrate this for you guys. What's the weather like in New York? Los Angeles. There you go. You see, at first I said New York, then I was like, oh, no. Let's talk about LA. And then it shows me the weather for LA, which is pretty cool. Now you can make mistakes and you can correct them while you're talking and it will be able to understand you. Minor upgrade, but a very, very useful one, if I might say so myself. The second feature is in your Photos application. Now we have cleanup. So if you have a picture and, for example, I don't want my friend to be there. I just want to be with me with the bike. So how do you remove that person? Previously, you had to go to third-party applications that would do this for you, but now inside the application, you go to edit and then you have cleanup. And in cleanup, you can just tap, doesn't want to tap right now, but you can just circle around the person that you don't want. It selects them and then it removes them. And then there you go, done. It has removed anything from the background. Sometimes it is good, sometimes it is not. Like, for example, I want to remove this bicycle. Will it be able to? Will it not be able to? I circle around it, selects the bike, and you can see it selects the shadow as well. And then it's gone. So it's just me out in the middle of nowhere without my bicycle. So, you know, you get the gist. So this is one of the new features, and it's quite welcome, I must say. Okay, so this is where Apple Intelligence gets its money's worth. Let's say you're writing a message. Hello, my name is Joe. And you're like, no. I want it to be something different. Then you select it, and then you go to Writing Tools. And then you pull up Writing Tools. You can proofread, you can rewrite, you can be friendly or professional or concise. Even you can summarize like articles or key points from any kind of text. You can list it or table. There are many options. This compose button is only in iOS 18.2. This phone is running iOS 18.2 right now. There will be a video about that later on, not yet. But what you have with iOS 18.1 right now is the proofread, rewrite, friendly, professional, concise, and the summary options and key points and lists and tables. So if we go into notes, you can see that there's a special little button over here too. You tap on here, and then you can see that you can proofread, rewrite, friendly, or make a list from any kind of text that you want. In the notes, it selects everything and it does that for you, which is a great addition. So, you know, this is great if you are having problems. If you want to write an email, you can use it there. If you want to write a message in WhatsApp or WeChat or wherever you're writing your messages, you can do that. So Apple Intelligence is here and it's just going to get better. The third new thing is the revamped Control Center. Now, with iOS 18, we had a new Control Center, but with iOS 18.1, we have more capabilities over here. As you can see, gone is the connectivity little square, and now we can put our own connectivity controls up here. So if I go and I want to add a control, you just go down, And you see, this was the old one, the connectivity, and now everything is fully separate and you have a lot more things to choose from. And third parties are actually adding their own widgets over here too, or controls over here too. There is a lot to choose from. I highly suggest that you go and check it out and customize your control center even more to the way you like it. By the way, this is mine. I want to know what you guys think of this setup. And finally, last but not least, is call recording. So if you want to call someone and you want to record the conversation, you can do that now. So all you need to do is go into the phone, dial a number. I just called my telephone carrier, and here you can see that there's this little icon. So I tap on this, and now the call is being recorded. And this call is being recorded to your Notes application. And it is, as you can see, take notes on this call. I tap, it takes me directly to the Notes application where it is recording, and then it's going to transcribe this phone call. So you will be able to see who said what. So now I'm gonna hang up over here. And then as you can see, view saved call, very good. I tap into this. And there you go. What I said, what they said, what I said, what they said. Now, this is not in English, so it didn't really transcribe it good. It only works good in English. So if you are not talking to an English person, it's not going to transcribe their text. Be aware of that. But if you are using it in English, there should be no problems. And this works on older devices too. iPhone 11, iPhone 12, 13, 14, 15, and obviously the new ones, 16. So you have call recording, you have the new Siri, you have writing tools, you have the cleanup, and you have the revamped control center. These are the top five new features of iOS 18.1. Did you download? What are you thinking? Did you get past the activation or the wait list? Hit me down in the comment section below and let me know. Until the next video, stay safe and hang loose.